I was born in Peoria, Illinois, in 1919, so I'm almost 100. And let's see, what else did we have a brother, younger brother, had one, he's gone, and a sister. My brother was Dick Telford, and my sister was Mary Louise, and she was the youngest. And he was working with Austin Western Road Machinery, and he was a salesperson, and they moved him, they transferred him, so we lived in quite a few houses. Not upsetting exactly, but I didn't have any early friends because you don't have time to make them. You know? Mm-hmm. And I just grew up and went to school and nothing special. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, I remember dances and meeting a guy I thought I liked and he dumped me. We were just grateful. We lived in South Carolina at the time. My father had been transferred there. And he had a $350 a month salary, and we were able to live on it. We were lucky to have it because people had no money. It was really sad. So we were in a house and we had plenty to eat until I didn't meet my husband until I went to FSU, and he saw me in the library and kept calling me, and I was a Chi Omega, so he knew where to find me. But he was 6 feet 5 when he was looking for a tall girl. And I filled the picture. I was pretty tall at that time. So, but I thought he was a royal pest. But I got that. He grew on me. So we finally wound up going steady and getting married. So it was a quite a gap, so I was scared. But when I got in it, I found I was a whole lot better than a lot of them were working there. So I felt really good. I got my confidence back because I hadn't worked, you know. Let's see. My husband died. All of them when my husband survived. It was wonderful. He was a wonderful guy. So, things didn't come easy. Well, I smoked a lot of cigarettes, like everybody did in those days. I just like to be with my college friends. And, you know, we just hung out together, like they do, like people do now. We weren't so different. My husband was a lieutenant in the field artillery, and was overseas for a year. He was in the field artillery group for 6 years, but he was only overseas for a year. But had saw a lot of combat. I was had a small child, Michael, who's now huge. He's 6'7" or something. I've forgotten, but anyway, I had a small boy, and so I had no money, and I had to go live with my parents during that time. So he tore up their living room quite well. But other than that, I just remember being very, very lonely and afraid that something was going to happen to him. He managed to come out of it alive, for which I was very grateful. But other than that, oh yeah, we had rationing. We had food stamps and we had gas stamps, and we can only use what we had. We use it like money. We had to give it over, and it was limited, of course. Why do you treat me so? He was the wartime president, and he took us through and did a wonderful job, I think. He didn't start the war. But once, I still remember listening to it. It was radio then, and I remember listening to the radio when he made the announcement that we were at war. And my husband was in the ROTC at the time, so of course he got caught up in it. Paul Rumsfeld was a friend, was comptroller of Michigan State University, so he was had the budget and everything. And he walked up to me in the hall one time when I was doing something about some of my studies. He said, "How would you like a job in the cashier's department?" I said, "I'll take anything you've got." You know, I worked in the cashier's office. Traveled with friends mostly. So went to Europe a couple of times. That's nice. Mm-hmm. I think I like France best. You put your head in.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
France. That was about it. I mean, and I knew a lot of people then, and we played a lot of bridge. We had bridge clubs, but all of my friends are gone now.
Yeah.
I'm the oldest living of our group. I do have one arm pusher, but she's not feeling very well. I earned my living at Michigan State when the first computers first came in. I fell in love with it, and I've got to see my computer room because I still do it. Got a nice computer that somebody built for me, and I've got all the mobiles, you know, so I still play with those, and I read that way. And you can get books for practically nothing, you know. And I do a lot of reading, and I do my finances on and that kind of thing. And I contact people that I know.
And you're on Facebook, right?
Pardon?
You have a Facebook?
Yeah. I'm on Facebook. You find me there.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, we get a little news flash at the top, as you know. Don't get me started on that president, please. I think that I was absolutely astonished that he was elected, frankly. I'm a Democrat. And always have been, in spite of my parents who were red hot Republicans. But I really am an independent because I vote for both people, for people in both parties, depending on their backgrounds. Mm-hmm. President Trump.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think? It's okay, you can say whatever you think. These girls won't care.
I think he's an absolute fool. I think he's dumb. I don't think he's experienced in what he does. And I think he's making mistakes. And I'm afraid for our country. And I wish he'd quit nibbling at North Korea. And causing problems there, you know, he's really looking for trouble there. So that's the way I feel about it.
Yes.
John F. Kennedy.
Why?
I don't know, he was intelligent. He did some things that I didn't care particularly for, but I liked him. I liked Franklin Roosevelt. I hated Nixon. God, I looking woman than I've ever heard.